introduction, like, we chose to do this project because we wanted to see, like, because, like, another group did for upperclassmen, the gender. So we wanted to see how age had a factor on how, like, how much of the hidden image we've seen in the upperclassmen.
I mean, we want to bring the image to that to images and stuff, but these images are optical. Optical illusions are the images that are perceived differently than what they really are. Our research goes more to the depth with this, with these images. And another experience before, of course, we identify our gender, and this is important with how gender can be a factor on how you see optical illusions. But ours does not how age could be a factor on how you see optical illusions.
So like for like I said earlier, we assume that older people, as in upperclassmen, which are juniors and seniors, will see more of the hidden image than the underclassmen, which are the freshmen and sophomores.
The purpose of this experiment was to go more in depth with optical illusions. And also, we've all seen optical illusions before, and we wanted to actually stop and think about them instead of just being amazed by them.
The variables were the independent variables, the age group. The dependent variable was what you need to see in the optical group. The control variable was the optical group. And the material that we were on the survey, the trainer, optical group.
Alright, so like you said, from the material survey. So for our survey, we had three questions. First one was, how old were you? The second question was, what grade were you in? And the third question is, how many of the five images have you seen before? So, like, we showed them in, we showed all five pictures, but with no, like, certain time frame. And if they seen more than three, if they seen three of the five images, then that means they wouldn't qualify for our experiment because they would already know the majority of the pictures.
We gave out the survey for the year, and we checked to see if they were qualified for our experiment. So if they seen two or less of the images, which we see here and here, to see better, two or less of them, then you qualify for our experiment. And if you qualify, you pick five each of the classes, and then five freshmen, five sophomores, five juniors and seniors, and the experiments come one at a time. Show them like one image for 3 seconds, and after the 3 seconds, we take the image away, and we ask them what they saw. If we ask them what they saw, we gather our data applied to our charts, and in our chart, you can see that 19 out of 25 of the freshmen, 76% of them saw the image with the same thing, and 24% of them did not. And for the sophomores, 21 out of 25 of the sophomores, meaning 84% of them did not see the hidden image, and 16% of them did not. And for the juniors, 22 out of 25 of them saw the hidden image, and 88%. 88% of them saw the image, and 12% of them did not. And for the seniors, 100% of them saw the image. In total, we all put together, 87% of them saw the image. If you look at the seniors compared to our freshmen, the seniors saw more images than the freshmen, which supported our hypothesis, and that our hypothesis was correct because the seniors would be able to see better than the freshmen. If you look at the chart here, you can see that as the age group gets older, then more of the hidden illusions were able to be seen, which also supported our hypothesis.
As he said, our data supported our hypothesis, and as the age groups got older, the percentage of the amount of images that they saw increased. And one thing that we learned from this experiment was that optical illusions, there are a variety of them, and each one does something differently. One thing that we could have done different was use optical illusions to hidden images instead of just one. Our results can lead to further studies or projects on how the eye works.
Do you guys think it was a like
social factor was the reason that older students could see it more, or was it like a brain development thing?
We thought like, I thought if you in school longer, your brain, and as old as you get, your brain gets more wiser and you have more knowledge and you process things easier than anybody. Like, say for instance, compare a freshman to a sixth grader, they would already know more because they've been through the sixth grader stage already.